want to introduce my son John and my daughter Claire, who are excited to be a part of the ride today. They were with me on the train ride from Des Moines to Council Bluffs, and this has been a great thing for us this summer to have a little fun together, to see this beautiful state. And we like the train so much that on Tuesday afternoon, we're actually taking Amtrak back from Chicago to Osceola to get us all home. So, what a great way to see our country and a great way to see our state. A special thanks to Iowa Interstate for making this train a possibility today. Thanks for coming out. And now, my friend and your congressman, Dave Lobsack.
I don't get a lot of time to get away with my wife, Terry, in this job. She's here today. We normally take time to ourselves on Sunday as much as we can, but the governor called me a couple weeks back, and we had a number of things to talk about, but this was one of them. He said, you want to hop on a train on a Sunday? We're going to go to Moline. I said, of course. This is a no-brainer. You know, this is fantastic. I'm really happy to be here. I want to thank the governor and his office, Jim LaRue, in particular, for putting this together. Iowa Interstate, and of course, Mayor Bailey and the Chamber of Commerce, and that wonderful letter that was read from my good friend Elliot Keller. We really owe Elliot, I think, a special thanks for doing everything he's done. You know, Mike, thank you very much. Let's say another thank you. So I first started running for this office way back in 2005. Of course, there weren't very many people who thought I could win. That's one story. But Elliot didn't care whether I was going to win or not. His job was to lobby any and every person he thought might have some influence when it came to passenger rail. He was one of the first people who talked to me, and that's what he talked about. That's what he kept talking to me about until I got elected, and that's what he's been talking to me about since I got elected. So Elliot is wonderful. I'm sorry he can't be here today. Just so you know, at the national level, we do have to devote significant funds to this, there's no doubt. We have to devote about $22 million or so to the Illinois portion of this route as well, and about $32 million or so to the Iowa portion. What happened recently is that my colleagues, two of my colleagues in Illinois, Bill Foster, who has sort of Aurora and west to almost to Iowa, and Phil Hare, Congressman Phil Hare, who's got the western part of Illinois, and our Congressman Bruce Bailey from Iowa, who's got the district a little bit east of mine over to the Quad Cities, and I, the four of us, wrote a letter to Transportation Secretary Ray LaHood, who, by the way, is from Illinois. I don't know if that's going to help us. I hope it does. But to him, to make sure that he knows that the recovery money that is available, several billion dollars, we want to make sure that he knows that we think that we've got to have $54 million for Illinois and for Iowa to make sure that we complete this in that time frame that Governor Culver's talking about. We wrote that letter. We're hoping to hear soon. We don't know the time frame on that. I'm going to continue to work with the Transportation Committee and the House of Representatives as well. This is absolutely critical for economic development, for the region, not just for Iowa City, but for Cedar Rapids, on to Des Moines, and eventually Omaha as well, for Iowa folks. And I'm so happy that the governor is doing all he can to promote this project. It's a long-term project in many ways, there's no doubt about it. But we've got to do what we can do now. And you're rallying today, you're continuing to rally. You know, I'm reading David McCullough's book on Harry Truman, and I feel a little like Harry Truman back here at the back of the train. He had bigger crowds.
Give him hell, Congressman!
There you go, thank you. And we're going to keep getting big crowds wherever we go. We're going to keep building those crowds. I know you're going to keep building the support for passenger rail from Chicago to Iowa City and throughout all of Iowa. Thank you very much for being here today. We're going to work as hard as we can on this. Thank you so much.
It's about 12:40. We're
going to
try and get back on and move in round one.
All right.
What do we got?
Hey, Ray. Nice to see you.
Try to make it sooner.
Okay.
We all got it.
Dave,
we're going to keep pushing.
Good to see you. Thank you so much.
Healthcare for real. Not better place than this.
You know about the Medicare thing that we just wrote? You haven't read about that yet.
No.
Check it out.
That's right. Well, but if we have real healthcare reform, we can get rid of Medicare.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Great day. All right, thank you. How are you?
Nice to see you.
See you. How are you? Oh, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you.
Hey, good to see you. Thanks for being here.
I was there with you for Al Green and Hitch.
So all right. Thank you. Yeah. Thanks for doing it.
My pleasure.
Yeah, great. Got the band out.
Okay, quick announcement.
Thank you guys. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you. Thanks,
you guys sound great.
Thank you
very much for doing
it. It's going to be one block down on the Buke Street here, so go to the Sunset and turn left and you'll see a shuttle there waiting for you. Anyone that's been invited, our elected officials, et cetera, that can ride the train, don't even worry about your own train.
Thanks for bringing them out today.
I'm all for public access television in Iowa City and everywhere. Thank you.
Governor, give us
thank you. Yes.
Oh, thank you. Very nice. Appreciate
thank
it.
You. Thanks for doing this.
All right.
Heard that.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Very excited.
Oh, great. All right. Hello, Iowa City Public Access Television. Great to be with you today. Go Rail!